I'm the Great Orbax. I'm here today with Dr. Mike Massa to discuss with you 1D kinematics. Mike?
All right. Let's do an example. The human body can handle accelerations up to 25 Gs, wow. 25 times 9.8 meters per second squared. So let's take a look at a car crash.
Okay.
Say you're driving along in a certain direction. Let's define the positive x direction here at 90 kilometers an hour.
All right, let's write some of this information down as we're actually going through the question. Okay. Try to keep track of everything all the way through.
Okay, so 90 kilometers an hour, typical in-town speeds. Let's convert that to SI units, 25 meters per second.
All right.
We're going to come to rest in this car crash, so the final velocity is going to be zero.
We physically stop.
Right. Now, 25 Gs, 25 times 9.8, that's 245 meters per second squared is our acceleration.
But we're actually slowing down in this case, right? We're going from a high velocity to a velocity of zero. So in this case, we're decelerating, we're slowing, and we have a negative value of that acceleration.
Perfect. So we can ask a couple questions. How quickly do you stop, and how far do you travel in that deceleration?
Okay. And we don't have those values.
Right.
Okay, so what we need to do is utilize our 1D kinematics equations to actually solve for these. Now, I typically default to always using this equation here.
Sure.
But in this case, I have two unknowns. If I'm trying to find delta x, I don't know delta t. If I'm trying to find delta t, I don't know delta x. So this one's useless to me right now.
All right.
So let's just go through the list. This one right here, this first one, has a final velocity, which we actually have, 0 meters per second, an initial velocity, which we also have, 25 meters per second, and we add that to an acceleration, minus 245 meters per second squared, multiplied by the differential in time that we experience. That makes it easy to solve for that delta t because we have all those values. So we bring that 25 over,
okay,
giving us a value of minus 25 divided by the minus 245 meters per second squared.
Okay, and that's
to solve for the time. Now we see we got minus and minus. That actually gives us a positive value for time, which is about 0.1 seconds.
Perfect. So a tenth of a second it takes for your body to come to rest.
Now that we actually have that time, we've got all the other variables that we need to solve for delta x. We could use any of these equations.
Sure.
Just sub in. Let's go with this last one. It's an easy setup. Delta x is equal to v initial plus v final divided by 2 multiplied by the change in time. Our initial velocity, again, is 25 meters per second. The final is 0 divided by 2 multiplied by that 0.1 seconds. Now, that basically gives us 12.5 times 0.1 or 1.25 meters. And that's the total distance that you travel during this time to slow from 25 meters per second down to 0.
That's about here. Crazy.